If you feel like performance max campaigns are a black box and you don't know what's going on, this video is for you. Hey, this is John from StubGroup. We are a premier Google partner digital advertising agency, and we help businesses dominate Google ads and make money online. So performance max campaigns, they are the latest and greatest, let's call that, in Google. They are super controversial, many different takes. Some agencies have stopped running them entirely. Other agencies run them exclusively. Everybody's got a perspective, but most people agree that it's challenging with the data within Google Ads that Google provides to understand where your ads are actually serving from a performance max campaign and how those different channels are performing. And Google intentionally obscures that because Google is, I should put it, not necessarily from a malicious perspective. Again, there's lots of controversy, but at the end of the day, you know, giving Google about the benefit of the doubt, what they're trying to accomplish is saying, hey, we, through our machine learning, can identify the right people to serve ads to, and we can serve ads to them in all sorts of different situations, on Google Search, Google Shopping, YouTube, on the Google Display Network websites, Gmail, Discover tab, etc. They're like, hey, tell us what you want to advertise and kind of who you want to advertise it to, and we'll figure out the best mix and places to show those ads to them. And sometimes that works great, and in an ideal world, that would be awesome, but it's easy for the system to run awry and for a lot of traffic and spend to come from channels that really don't make sense and that are not performing well for you. And it's hard to figure out what those are within the Google Ads interface. So how do you figure out what channels you're spending money on for performance max campaigns? Well, generally you need to leverage third-party tools. So different people have different tools they use. Some agencies use scripts to accomplish this. There's some really well-known scripts that are going around out there that kind of grab information, feed it into spreadsheets. Others use, you know, dashboards and things. We use a third-party tool ourselves that I'll kind of show you here on my screen to give you a sense of some of the data that we have access to. And this is, the scripts and programs and whatnot is pulling information from Google Ads API, which is basically the kind of spout of information that Google provides that you can pull from. And then they're using different criteria and learnings to estimate as much as possible what different channels, you know, impressions, clicks, cost, etc. is coming from. So it's not always perfect because it's not always, you know, the data that Google is providing does require some kind of parsing and inference by these third-party tools. But I believe it's generally fairly accurate and is a helpful signal that can give you, point you in the right direction of understanding where your money is being spent. So let me show you, for example, you know, what we do for our clients to be able to understand these metrics. So you can see here on my screen, pmax channel distribution. And so we can look at various metrics to identify what channels these different metrics are, how they are distributed across these channels. So let's start with impressions. For this particular campaign, for this particular client, in this particular date range, we see that 97% of the impressions are coming from the shopping network, 2% from display, 0% from video, 1% from other. What's other? Kind of oddly in this case, other includes search, so Google search, as well as, I believe, Gmail and Discover. It's kind of a weird collection of channels, but that's how it's formulated here. So we can see for this particular campaign, most of the impressions are coming from shopping. Then we can look at clicks. Okay, it's a fairly similar distribution, 93% of clicks from shopping versus 97% of impressions for shopping, 4% clicks for display, 2% for other. So fairly similar distribution. And then we've got cost. So here, 90% for shopping, 7% for other, which is interesting. So presumably a little bit of a higher cost per click for other, which is probably mostly search as compared to shopping and the other platforms. And then conversions, interesting. So 3% of conversions from other, 93% from shopping. And then conversion value, interesting. 4% from other, 92% from shopping. And then expected return on ad spend, super interesting. 50% for other versus 31% for shopping, 10% display, 9% video. And there's definitely some caveats for this ROAS number. And obviously it's hard to take into account, let's say, more top of funnel channels like video, where there's not as much direct attribution, but it may have fed some of the other channels. So you can't just blindly like take the numbers and be like, oh, you know what? Other has the best ROAS, so let's try and spend more money on other, because there's a lot of other nuance in it. But it's a helpful signal if you're seeing, for example, we've seen situations where a high percentage of, let's say, clicks and costs were coming from display, And that looked concerning. It looked like, hey, the quality of traffic we're probably getting from these campaigns is not great. And so sometimes you need to take action. Now, the action you can take is not telling Google, well, spend more on search or spend more on shopping, because you don't have those options available for PMax campaigns. But there are things that you can do. There are strategies you can take with how you apply feeds to campaigns, with what assets you do or don't provide to PMax campaigns. And sometimes also even resetting campaigns, like pausing one and creating a new one. Sometimes we've done that. Also sometimes running standard shopping campaigns alongside of Performance Max campaigns seems to actually push better performance to the Performance Max campaign and push more shopping distribution for the Performance Max campaigns for whatever reason. So at the end of the day, you know, step one is seeing the data and being able to identify what's going on. And then step two is analyzing the data and making decisions and, you know, based upon that data. So hopefully this is helpful to you. Again, not something that you can access directly from within the Google Ads interface, but it is available through different third-party reporting tools, through different scripts that are out there, and something that we leverage on behalf of our clients that we work with here at StubGroup. So if this information was helpful to you and you want more, tap that subscribe button and you'll see more in your feed. And until next time, this is John signing off.